Hello, today is Monday, May 20. My name is Aiden, and also with me are
Evie,
Ben,
Finn.
We are your news team for KDWW. First, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you. Here are the announcements. Moving On Up Day is on Wednesday, May 22nd. This is a time for students to visit their next year grade level and for fifth graders to go back to kindergarten. This will be held at 2:15 p.m. Friday, May 24th is Field Day, and students, tell your parents that we need volunteers to help during this event. Grades 3 through 5 participate in the morning session, and grades K through 2 participate in the afternoon session. Next Monday, there is no school because of Memorial Day. Our last day of school for this year is next Thursday, May 30th. Please bring back all library books if you still have any out. Chromebook collection begins this week in kindergarten and continues next Wednesday with everyone else. That's all for the announcements. Now it's time for the lunch menu.
Thank you. Here's the lunch menu for this week. On Monday, it will be French toast sticks with a cheese omelet and hash brown patties. For Tuesday, look for chicken tenders and steamed carrots and baked beans and Cheeto puffs. On Wednesday, we'll have cheeseburger, mac and cheese with steamed carrots. For Thursday, it will be dumplings with fried rice and steamed green beans. And for Friday, we'll have Bosco cheese sticks with marinara sauce and a dark green salad. I'm looking forward to, I don't know.
Tuesday.
Monday.
Tuesday.
Now it's time for the weather. A pretty normal spring week is ahead for us. Here's to hoping we have no more smoky skies from the Canada wildfires. Highs will be in the 60s and 70s. There is a chance for more rain.
Thank you, Ben. It's time to check in on our top stories. Here they are.
Hi, I'm Finn.
And I'm Ben.
And we're this week's KDWW news team. And here today are
Ben,
Kai,
Eliza.
And we're going to be asking them what their favorite memory of this year so far is.
My favorite memory of this year is probably all these videos we've been taking.
My favorite years, I'm going to make butterfly.
My favorite part is when we got our Gaga ball pit.
What's your mind?
When Brooks threw a dot to me in football and he was hopping on one leg.
Well, I remember that.
And now we have a special announcement for all the elementary schools. This is just a reminder that all library books are due back at school on Friday, May 17th.
Everyone who has books checked out, it is time for you to be a detective. Ask your grown-ups at home to help you find your books.
Look
everywhere. Under a bed, in your backpack, on tables, in your desk, in your car, or reading areas in your classroom.
You can all have your school meet at school. Let's get all the books back by May 17th.
We'd love to return to school in the fall with all the books back on the shelves.
This week on Signs of Spring, it's our final episode. So, let's look back at the last 10 weeks in our recap. These are listed in the order of their appearance on Signs of Spring. We started off with the first red-winged blackbirds. They were back 9 days earlier this year. And then we took a look at the frost leaving the ground, which happened about a month earlier than the median date because of our crazy warm winter. The first western chorus frogs were heard pretty much right on schedule, April 4th. Mama barred owl's first egg hatched on March 31st, which was about a week earlier. The last measurable snowfall took place March 26th, 19 days earlier than the median date. The green wave reached us by the time we got to mid-April, just a few days ahead of schedule. The first dandelions appeared around April 13th, about 2 weeks earlier than what we typically see in spring. The first eastern bluebird eggs were laid in their box on April 20th. That occurred about 18 days earlier than the median date. The wood warblers returned the first week of May, which was pretty much right on schedule. And the lilacs, which is typically been that midpoint of spring, they started blooming around May 12th, which was a few days earlier than the median first date. So signs of spring might be over, but phenology never stops. Remember, you can make observations of the changes in the weather, plants, and animals throughout the entire year, not just spring. As you go through the summer months, make note of some key phenological events. For example, when do the cicadas start buzzing? When do crickets start chirping? When do acorns start falling? There is always something to be observing outside. Have a great summer, phenologists.
Next up is the answer to our trivia question from last week. The question was, how many doors are in Westwood? What do you guys think?
I think 96.
I'd say probably like 250.
That's
a 5,238.
I'd say 121. Here's the answer.
Hey, I'm Aiden from the KDWW News Team. I'm here with
Dawson,
Ashlyn.
What grade are you guys?
I'm second, Mrs. Cross.
Second, Mrs. Cross.
Okay, the question is, how many doors are in Westwood outside?
28 doors.
So, that's the answer. Bye.
That's a lot of doors.
I did not know that there were that many doors in Westwood.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even know.
Finally today, it's our time for a laugh segment. Remember, the trivia question is to make you think. It's not about searching Google for the answer. It's about talking with classmates and staff to figure it out. So let's take a look. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ava, and I'm with KDWW, and today I'm interviewing
Elton.
And whose class are you in?
Mrs. Betts.
Okay, and this is your trivia question for this week.
What's the most popular name in the school?
Okay, that's all from KDWW. Bye!
That's all for this edition of KDWW. Thanks for watching. We hope you have a great day and
remember to do things the Wildcat way.